after the tragic events, of course, at Astroworld Festival, many parents, like myself, found ourselves tackling some really difficult questions from our kids, leaving many of us with their own questions of really, how do we answer them?
Yeah, a lot of parents in that same boat. Here to help us navigate those questions is licensed professional counselor, Dr. Shayna D. Lewis. Dr. Lewis, it's great to have you back on Houston Life. So this story has been everywhere. It's been on the news, it's been on social media. How do we begin this conversation with the young people in our lives?
This is a tough one. This is really tough. We need to ask our kids what they know about it. My children are teens and they knew more than I did. So it's asking them, what do they know about it? What have they heard about it? And keeping your information age appropriate, because younger children can't really hold the whole capacity of what happened. Older children can perhaps hold a lot more. I'd say ask them their thoughts, ask them what they know. Keep it age appropriate. And if you have children who are very prone to anxiety, make sure you limit their exposure to media, because the images, the sounds, all of the things that they are seeing is distressing. And as parents, we have to be able to monitor and minimize that as much as possible. Now, the other thing you want to make sure you do is instill a sense of safety for your kids, because this is something that has made them not feel safe. Why? Because trauma changes how we see ourselves, other people, and the world. And this happening seems as if the world is not safe anymore. So make sure your kids feel safe. And make sure you don't dismiss their feelings, because even though they may not know the folks who were involved, there were children who were lost. Honor their feelings about this situation. Do not dismiss them. Talk to them. They really have something to say. And make sure you pay attention to your children. They may be responding by being anxious, having nightmares, not being able to focus or sleep. And if you see things that are out of the ordinary, make sure you seek professional help. You don't have to do this alone. Our kids need us, and they may need some additional help too.
That is so true. And keeping that open line of communication is so important, even if it's a little bit at a time, you know, if they're ready to open up or they're ready to ask more questions. I think that that is so important, Dr. Lewis. You know, two of the youngest victims will be laid to rest later this week. And so there's going to be a lot of young adults going to this. And so once we're dealing with loss, but in those moments of a funeral or a memorial service, that too can have a different effect on what they have felt with this past week.
It does. It does, because you think about funerals are, this is what makes it very real. Up until now, there are things that we've heard, but a funeral makes it very real. Images that we see of folks being laid to rest make this very real. And we want to make sure we support our children around this. COVID-19 already put our kids in a grieving process. And this kind of grief, even though they may not know these young people, they still feel the impact, because they may have thought, that could have been me. That could have been a friend of mine. And when you watch other young people hurt and be in pain, our children do take that on. So absolutely pay attention and limit their exposure if you can to more than what they can actually handle emotionally.
Dr. Lewis, I feel like a lot of parents are stuck in this situation where they don't want to shield their child too much from the reality of, you know, what's happening in the world. And at the same time, they want to be honest with them and respect their boundaries. For young people who don't really seem ready to talk about difficult things, specifically the tragic events of Astroworld over the weekend, at what point does the parent step in and say, you know what, maybe you're not ready for this conversation, but we're going to have this conversation?
This is a case, Derek, where you got to know your kids, because some children are very anxious. And if you force conversations that they're not ready to have, you can incite more anxiety. You want to make sure you prepare your children, right, for the world and what could potentially happen. Sometimes you want to wait, and maybe now may not be the right time. They could have nightmares, they could feel depression or anxiety, loss of focus, be afraid that they could be harmed if you continue to press a conversation that they're not ready. You want to make sure they have coping mechanisms in place before you have a conversation that they may not be ready to have, that may send them into greater areas of emotional distress. So we just want to, as parents, do what's best for our kiddos in the moment, support them, listen to them, seek help if you need to, so that they know that they are not alone.
Dr. Shana Lewis, you're always a wonderful guest and great insight. The clinical director of Living Well Professional Counseling Services. It's always great to check in with you.
Thank you for having me.
And for more tips from Dr. Shana, text AstroWorld to 55444. We'll also share a link to her site on our website. That's HoustonLife.tv.